Hello everyone, my name is Alberto Alvarez. I'm an academic customer success engineer at MathWorks. I work closely with university professors and researchers, and I help them with the use of MATLAB and Simulink, especially in the field of wireless communications. And in today's video, I'll show you how to build waveforms without writing a single line of code, so you can easily teach or learn digital communications. From an educational perspective, the content that I'm sharing today is mostly intended for professors teaching baseline digital modulations. This is typically shown in courses such as communication theory, digital communications, cellular and mobile communications, and the like, though this might vary from university to university or from country to country. Now, students might get lost in the math sometimes. They usually don't know what the key parameters are in a given digital modulation. So I'll put the mathematical analysis aside and I'll build digital waveforms interactively. Your students will be able to visualize what happens if they increase the modulation order of a QEM waveform with a Gaussian channel. What happens if they set, for example, a longer or shorter effective length in an OFDM. If they have impairments such as fade noise. And since I will be working with a MATLAB app, programming skills are not entirely required. We are going to be using a graphical user interface that MATLAB provides called Wireless Waveform Generator. So we first build our given waveform, say for example, QEM, OFDM, or even the standard compliant waveforms for 5G or LTE. Then we can add impairments if we want, such as noise, frequency offset, IQ imbalance, and some other effects. Then we can visualize our waveform constellation diagram, or spectrum, or the resource grid if we are talking about OFDM-based waveforms. Then we can export it into the MATLAB workspace. And finally, we can transmit it if we have some sort of device like an SDR or any other hardware equipment. Now let's jump into MATLAB to see how we can build a waveform using this app. To open the wireless waveform generator, you can just type wireless waveform generator in the command window. Or you can go to the Apps tab that is up here. You see that it's already shown here as the first one. This is just because these are my favorite apps. But if it's not shown here, you can go to the scroll down menu and go down to the Signal Processing and Communications section. And here you will just click on Wireless Waveform Generator. Now, when it opens, you need to select a waveform type. You see here different options. We will stick by now with QEM. And now say that you want to generate a very simple QPSK. So in the left-hand side of the window, you will see modulation order, simple mapping, and any and other parameters. We will stick to the modulation order of 4 so we can generate the QPSK. And MATLAB is already generating automatically an array for having the input bits. And we're just going to add a transmitting filter. We can say use a normal raised cosine. These parameters are fine. And then we just need to click on the generate button to actually generate our waveform. You'll see the time scope with the real and imaginary part, the spectrum of the signal, and the constellation diagram. Now say that you want to add some noise, then we will go to the impairments button. And again, in the left-hand side, you'll see the impairments section. Let's just add additive Y Gaussian noise. And let's set a 10 dB signal to noise ratio. Then we can just click again in generate. And we will see the same waveform that we generated before, but just adding some noise that it's basically shown in the constellation diagram when you can see the QPSK symbols, but sort of distorted. Now we can export our waveform with the export button. We have different options. We can export all of the variables that generate this waveform to our workspace. We can export the whole thing in a math file. We can even export it to a Simulink model, but I'm going to be using the export MATLAB script option. So MATLAB just automatically generated the whole code for first generating the waveform, then adding the impairments, and then visualizing timescope, spectrum analyzer, and the constellation diagram. So you see the code is very clean and it's partially commented. Now let's generate a much more complex OFDM waveform. Again, in the left-hand side of the screen, you'll see all the relevant parameters for generating the waveform, FFT length, that I can keep it to 64, garbage subcarriers. We can even add a new subcarrier in the DC component, cyclic prefix length, and some other parameters. Now let's put a 16 QEM modulation for each subcarrier. So again, we can go to the modulation order and just select 16. You see that MATLAB is doing by its own, generated by its own, the input spin array that is based on the modulation order, the number of subcarriers, and the number of data subcarriers. So just like we did before, we click in the generate button. And this time we will see spectrum analyzer, constellation diagram, but also the resource grid in the OFDM subcarrier mapping. So you see that MATLAB is putting different colors depending on the subcarrier type: gray for the noob DC subcarrier, light blue for the garband subcarriers, and dark blue for the data subcarriers. If we want to export this waveform to a MATLAB script, again, we go to the Export button and click in Export MATLAB script. As in the QPSK example, you'll see the section that generates the OFDM waveform and the visualized section with the spectrum analyzer, constellation diagram, and the resource grid mapping. There is no impairment section this time since we are not adding any impairments at all. Now, before we finish, just let me show you that by clicking this button, you have many other type of waveforms. You have standard compliant systems like 5G, LTE, WLAN, even Bluetooth, satellite, and radar. And by clicking in the transmitter tab, you can actually transmit the waveform that you just generated using hardware, instruments, USRPs, or even software-defined radio devices. Now, as a summary, with the Wireless Waveform Generator app, you can generate custom or standard compliant waveforms, add impairments, visualize the constellation, spectrum, resource grid, export the waveform that you generated to the MATLAB workspace, and finally transmitted if you have the corresponding hardware. So that was everything from my side. I hope you enjoyed the video. Subscribe to our channel if you like the content, and stay tuned for upcoming videos. See you soon.